Brr. It's cold out there.
All right, hello everybody and welcome. My name is Matt and it's really cold outside. This Jeep, by the way, I'm in a Jeep if you haven't noticed. This is not the Mustang and it's definitely not the motorcycle. I know I typically do this stuff on a motorcycle because motor vlog. Well, if you notice here, this Jeep is, it's actually a black Jeep, but you wouldn't be able to tell by looking at it from the outside because it's covered in snow. It's like the end of April, get into the couple days away from the 1st of May and it's snowing and it's a miserable snow. It came out of nowhere and it's not gonna stop me from doing car news though, because you know what? The news does not stop for the weather. So before we get into the news, just a little bit about this Jeep. This is actually my daily driver. No, I don't always daily the Mustang. This Jeep is for weather like this and for off-roading. It's a 2010 and it's pretty nice. I like it. It's a Jeep, so you'll have to excuse some extra camera jitter there. I hard mount that camera onto the windshield there. So we'll just have to deal with that because the suspension isn't what it is in the Mustang. It's a little smoother in the Mustang, believe it or not. Solid axle Jeep, front and rear, that's just how they are, and that's why they are amazing. Now let's get into the news, because like I said, the news doesn't stop for the weather, so I can't stop either. And what we've got, first bit of news I've got for you is about Elon Musk and how he's totally gone off the deep end. And I mean literally, as in deep end. He's got this idea in his head that he wants to build a system of underground tunnels, underground highways. Now, back in December, he sent out a tweet, said something to the effect of, wow, traffic sucks. I'm just gonna buy a boring machine, as in a tunnel boring machine, and just dig a hole and just keep digging. Never thought, oh, that's funny, he's just being silly. And then later he tweets out, no, really, I'm actually gonna do this. And so it's come out that he has, let me merge over here, that he's started a new company called The Boring Company. And now this isn't boring as in something that is boring and unentertaining. This is boring as something is boring a hole. Something's digging a tunnel. Yeah, and he's totally serious with this. He's bought some boring machines. And he's like, you know what? Let's dig some tunnels and let's build some roads. Reason this is news now, even though he tweeted about this back in December, is because on the Boring Company YouTube channel, there is a new video, their first video, which demonstrates what this concept is going to look like. Now, I suggest checking this out. It's been out for one day as of recording this, and it's already number two on trending on YouTube. It's the second highest trending video of today. And with that in mind, it's well done. It's interesting to see yet another one of Elon Musk's delusions for the future. Now it is actually, I mean, granted, it's a cool idea. What you do basically is you load your car up on a platform that will be located somewhere on the side of the street. And when you do that, the platform goes underground and hooks up to a rail system. So you're not actually driving your car underground, you're just sitting atop a platform which is on rails, like a little train, like a little subway underground. And it's kind of a neat idea because when you have a lot of cars, you get this congestion, you get automotive accidents, you get people being stupid in traffic jams, hence why traffic jams happen, is because people are being stupid. This eliminates that because you're not actually in control of the vehicle. Yes, it's your car. No, it doesn't take control of your car. You're just on a platform cruising around underground, underneath different things, and totally bypassing the road system. Now, my first impression looking at this video was, well, it looks like something that only, there's probably gonna be a toll for it. Obviously, it's probably gonna be some kind of tollway. And in addition to that, it's probably gonna be ludicrously expensive. Like, when you think about it, this premium system that you load your car onto, you hop out of traffic to load your car onto it, and yeah, that's gonna be expensive. Oh yeah, oh yeah. And of course, the video would lead you to believe that yes, you have to drive a Tesla in order to get on this system. That's not the case, but every single car in this shot, in this video, that's in the tunnel system at least, that is a Tesla. So, and you'll have to excuse the windshield wipers making some noise over there. Moving on into the next piece of news, I'm gonna be talking about Mitsubishi and a new hybrid, but normally wouldn't talk about a hybrid. What I am gonna talk about though is how they're celebrating their 100th year anniversary of their first production car. They have the Mitsubishi Model A, which was, again, Mitsubishi's first production car, came out in 1917, and they're celebrating the 100th year anniversary of that by hooking up with, get this, West Coast Customs. You wouldn't expect that, but they're hooking up with West Coast Customs to make a Mitsubishi Model A sort of reproduction custom car thing. I don't know what to call it. It's going to be based off of a Mitsubishi Outlander, and it's going to have, quoting them, rally-inspired four-wheel drive in a Model A. That looks a bit something like this. Yeah, that... okay, that's going to be cool. I honestly can't wait to see that. That will be really neat, and who knows? It'll be obviously a one-off vehicle. It'll probably tour some car shows. We'll get some neat pictures of it, and it'll just show what can really be done with modern technology and old school, and I mean really old school, design. And, oh yeah, and I should also mention, it's gonna be a hybrid. Yeah, it's gonna be a hybrid Mitsubishi Outlander hybrid Model A monstrosity of stuff and weirdness. And again, it's a hybrid. I don't normally talk about hybrids, but when they look like this, and that's kind of cool. That's kind of cool. It's a hybrid, and it looks like that. I don't know. And that might not be what the finished production one will look like. That's obviously just an actual Mitsubishi Model A, which I'm not sure where that fits in the car realm, because you've got the, you know, the Ford, the Model T. It seemed like back in the day, the hip and trend thing to do was to name your car after letters. Now, getting into my last piece of news, yes, I know three stories. It's kind of a short one today, but that's because the weather sucks. The roads, they're just wet. It's miserable. It's cold. Like, the snow, it's wasting my time. Unless it snows a lot, like a foot of snow, and it covers everything, and nobody has to go to work or school or whatever, that's a good day. That's like, okay, cool, this is kind of novel. When it's just wet and cold like this without any real benefit, I don't know. It's like, stop wasting my time, Mother Nature. I've got better things to be doing. All right. Getting off of that soapbox and getting into the news again, last story, it's about the Hennessy Exorcist. Now, I talked about this a couple weeks ago. Now, what's cool is Hennessy just posted a video of some official dyno runs of the thing, and man, does it sound mean on the dyno runs. Go check out the video. It's definitely just worth hearing that supercharger wind up and seeing what those power figures are. Now, speaking of the power figures, it's going to be 959 horsepower with 756 pound-feet of torque, and that's to the wheels. That's wheel horsepower. Now, to the crank, it's going to be 1,103 horsepower to the crank. I mean, man, that is a lot of power. Now, there's a lot of debate about this between the Demon and the Exorcist, because people are like, the Exorcist, it's not really a production car. It's only 100 cars. Well, that's true. It's only 100 cars, and it may, in fact, cost more than the Dodge Demon. We don't know yet, because the price figures for the Dodge Demon are not out yet. However, it's rumored to cost just below $100,000, and this Exorcist costs just above $100,000. So, you know, if you've got that kind of money to spend, you might find yourself torn between a Demon or an Exorcist. Now, should you go with the Exorcist, bear in mind that those are going to be a limited run, 100 cars per year. We'll see what they do in upcoming years, but so far it's looking like it's going to be more of a one-off car. 100 cars per year. Now, you can take a Camaro and give Hennessy $55,000 on top of the price of the Camaro, and make it, you know, have 1,000 horsepower. Yes, that is cool, but on the same token, you can pretty much take any car to Hennessy, give them $55,000, and they'll make it run a 9-second quarter mile. Wonder if you could take a Jeep to them, have them make it run nines. Probably not, but you get the idea. The Exorcist, it's a really neat car. I like the idea of it. I like the idea of the muscle car wars, you know? You've got the, you know, Exorcist again, power numbers, 959 horsepower, 756 pound-feet of torque. In comparison to the Dodge Demon's 840 horsepower and 770 pound-feet of torque. Now, with that 770 pound-feet of torque, that's actually more in the Demon than the Exorcist. The Exorcist has slightly less torque than the Demon, but I think that's such an insignificant difference that that's not really going to be a major selling point. Now, finishing up my thoughts here on the Hennessy Exorcist Camaro. Look, it's the Dodge Demon, there's going to be about 3,000 units. The Exorcist, there's going to be more like 100 units. I don't know. Yes, maybe that qualifies as a production car technically. I don't really think so. You're not going to see a whole lot of those. Is it amazing and awesome and cool that you can buy a Camaro with 1,000 horsepower? Oh yeah, that's fantastic. That's awesome. If I had the money, I don't know if I would go with the Exorcist. I don't know if I would necessarily go with the Demon. I might be inclined to save some money and go with a car that you could actually drive every day, like, I don't know, a Hellcat? Like, oh, reasonable? Save your money and go with something reasonable, reserved, and just get a Hellcat. Just get a Hellcat. Now, in review, it talked about Elon Musk, how he's gone off the deep end and he's just going to spend his life digging holes. Talked about Mitsubishi and their Model A and how they're going to make a new one that's actually a Mitsubishi Outlander. But, hey, yeah, that's pretty cool. That's pretty cool. And then finally, of course, the Exorcist Camaro, 1,000 horsepower, ridiculousness. Only 100 of them per year? I don't know. Now, anyways, I'm Matt. I'm going to finish this up. I'm going to get somewhere warm. Now, of course, between episodes here, you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter at Sir Matt West. Now, it's not just going to be car news coming up here on the channel. With the warm weather, I'm going to get back on the bike, going to get back into some moto vlogs, going to be covering some events, Streetcar Takeover, Denver, going to be there. I'm going to be covering a lot of cool events as this weather warms up, so you're definitely going to want to subscribe to check that out. And of course, like I said, follow me on social media to hear more about that. Now, I'm Matt, and I'm going to try not to freeze to death. You'll be seeing me in the next video. Bam!